Thursday, loves. I am praying that my dogs don't start barking because there are dogs in the neighborhood that are having a conversation right now. And she'll be quiet, and as soon as I start to go do a video or as soon as I go to do something, she starts barking. All right, so October, the first week of October is Mental Illness Awareness Week. And tonight we are talking about National Depression Screening Day. So why are these screenings so important anyway? Depression is a serious medical condition. It's harmful to the body. It takes a toll on our body and on our mind. Depression can affect anyone, regardless of age, race, socioeconomic status. Getting screened is an effective first step in both spotting the depression as well as combating this illness. And depression, according to Mental Health America, depression is widespread. It affects over 16 million Americans each year. So that's why I said, let's talk about this topic tonight. So first we're gonna start with common symptoms of depression. So some common symptoms, thoughts of death, not wanting to live anymore. I just wanna go to sleep and not wake up. Feelings of worthlessness, hopelessness. What's the point of all of this? What's the point of this anyway? Oh, my mom is saying hi. Hi. Hi from Princeton. Agitation, constantly feeling down or feeling in a sad mood. Now, some lesser known symptoms. These are some symptoms that maybe are a little bit hidden or not as presentable. Loss of interest, if you notice that you're not enjoying the things that you used to enjoy anymore, or the things that used to bring you joy. Fatigue or loss of energy, a diminished ability to concentrate or think, focus, you know, appetite or weight changes. So those are some of the less common. The less known, that tends to hide a little bit more. So what are some solutions? We talked about the symptoms there, some common symptoms and some less known symptoms. So what are the solutions? Screenings are not a professional diagnosis. Screenings point out the presence or absence of depressive symptoms. So this is just the point of this conversation, is to bring a little bit of awareness. Perhaps you've been feeling a little down, a little tired, noticing that you're not enjoying things like you used to. You're not sleeping like you used to, or maybe you're sleeping too much. This is a good way to give you some clarity as to whether or not you may have depression. Now, this doesn't, like I said just now, this doesn't mean you have that diagnosis. This is a good sign to seek professional help. Talk to a doctor or a licensed clinician. For example, if you're watching this video and you think that you may be experiencing depression, feel free to send me a message. So in the meantime, I want to give you some professional help line here, SAMHSA, which is the Substance Abuse and Mental Health Services Administration. Their national helpline is 1-800-622-HELP. You can also go on mhascreening.org for a confidential and anonymous screening. If you have further questions or you're not really sure, you can just hop on that website. It's free, it's confidential, it's anonymous. They have just questions on there and you just answer it, click it. You could do it from your phone. So what can you do in the meantime? In the meantime, pay attention to your thoughts. What are you telling yourself? So if you ever read the comic strips and you see that somebody's thinking about something, right? It kind of looks like a thought bubble. Be mindful. What are you telling yourself that's got you feeling so down? Surround yourself with support. Stay connected to people. Stay connected. Depending on where you are and the laws with the quarantine, you know, if you are unable to connect with people in person or face to face, connect with them on the phone, FaceTime, Zoom. Stay connected to people. Watch your favorite movies. Hey Jeff, thanks for joining me tonight. And AJ's on there too. Watch your favorite movies. Do soothing things. Wear comfy clothes. Do some journaling, writing down some thoughts, things that you're noticing are recurring in your mind. Hey Scott, thanks for joining me. Take a relaxing shower or a bath with some essential oils. In case you're not really too familiar with essential oils, lavender, chamomile, sandalwood, those are some of my favorite ones. They're very calming. exercise. I know some people are just not about exercising. I can't tell you, it wasn't until I started exercising and really getting with someone who really knows what they're doing. Hi, Blair. How impactful exercising is. When I go for too long and I don't exercise, I notice that I'm constantly, hey Lakshmi, I'm constantly having breakdowns, mental and emotional breakdowns. Why is that? That's because my body is absorbing the stress and it's holding on to that stress. Moving around, exercising gives your body the chance to relieve the stress, alleviate some of the tension that your muscles have been holding on to. If you think about in primitive days, right, when we're trying to survive, what are the things we're staying alive from? We're trying to stay alive and running from a bear, running from a tiger, trying basically to survive, so our adrenaline is constantly up. Nowadays, stress looks like making ends meet. Bills, maybe an argument or a disagreement with our partner or family members. So stress looks a little different nowadays. We don't realize our body is holding on to that. Our muscles are holding on to that. Exercising helps to work that stress out. It helps to alleviate it. So exercise really does make a big difference when it comes to depression. Okay, so we talked a little bit about the common symptoms, the less common symptoms, right? Why we're even having this conversation, how it looks like maybe for you, but how can you tell if someone else is experiencing depression? So some ways to tell if someone else might be experiencing depression: they're much more quiet than usual. You notice that they use the excuse, I'm tired, a lot. They've lost their appetite. They constantly look at the ground. They want to be alone a lot. They might smile for a moment and then just go right back to a blank expression right after. They struggle to engage in conversation. They become withdrawn or emotionally distant. They become apathetic to things that they'd usually be engaged in. So say, for instance, you have started to notice these signs in other people or in someone close to you. What do you do? What can you do? The first thing to do is be a support. Listen, ask them, hey, what's up? I notice you've been down. What's going on? What's really going on with you? Are you okay? Have you been struggling? Have you been going through anything? You know I'm here for you. Listen. And after you say all these things, give them a space to just talk and vent without any judgment. And after you've listened to them, have empathy. Understand that it's not just a matter of, well, can you just do this? Can you just try? Why aren't you trying? Can you just do? It's depression. So it's physiologically speaking as well. Sometimes it's not as easy when we struggle with depression. It's all in here. So we can look fine on the outside and still experience depression on the inside. After you've been encouraging them, after you've had empathy, you've been listening, you've been a support, encourage them to seek professional help. And how do we do that? By encouraging them from a space of love, saying, you know, I really do care about you. I love listening. I love being here for you. But have you thought of maybe seeking someone who is a little bit of a better support than I can be? So as I always say whenever I do these lives, if you find this helpful, please share this information. If you think this may help someone else, please feel free to send this to them. If something came up for you, or if you think that someone you know may be depressed and you're interested in learning more, if you have any questions or just anything at all, feel free to send me a message either here on Facebook or you can email me. My email is Dani, D-A-N-I, at DaniLiberi.com. If this was your first time checking out my live, thank you so much for checking it out. I didn't even introduce myself. I just realized that. My name is Dani Liberi. I'm a virtual licensed psychotherapist and a happiness transformation coach. And I typically work with people who are feeling unhappy, unfulfilled, overwhelmed, anxious, stressed out. So I hope this information was helpful. Like I said, please send me a message if you have any questions or if anything came up for you during this live. If nothing else, take care of yourselves. Thank you so much for joining me and have a great night.